You see, so you keep your dignity. But you see the way women expose themselves, run after men, then how can we complain there is rape and all that? I mean, we want it as if the way we are on, as if we want all this attention of men, dirty attention of men. But Sahajyoginis are not like that. They are dignified. They have their own, they have their own voice. And they have respect for themselves because they are yoginis. They have light above their head. They are special people. So we have to really decondition ourselves a little bit. Especially the ego part, which is very, very developed in the West, should be brought down by women. I'll tell you one incident how I brought down the ego of a saint. Once, you know, I went to see some saint who was living in a very high mountain. He was an evolved soul but a man, you see, so he had some ego, I think, in him. So, it started raining very heavily. And it would not stop. And it was said that this saint could control the rain. And he got very upset when I went up there. He was just going on like this, like that, feeling very bad about the whole thing, that he could not control the rain. So he came later on when I went and sat down. I was all drenched, you see. So he came and he touched my feet, of course, that he did. But then he said, Mother, why did you not allow me to control the rain? Is it that you wanted to control my ego? No, not at all. I didn't want to control your ego by any chance. Then why did you not allow me to stop the rain? So I said, this problem is like this. You are a saint and a sannyasi, you see. And you bought a sari for me. And I can't take a sari from a sannyasi. But if I get drenched, then I can easily take the sari. Very sweetly I told him, So he said, you know, I have a sari for you. And he didn't know what to answer. Then I told him that you regard me as Adi Shakti, isn't it? Yes, yes. He said, yes, I do. You have greater powers. I said, that's not the point. But when I was coming, I thought if the rain flows over my body, then the whole thing will get vibrated and you will have a very lush area here. That's why I wanted to do that.
Alors, quand je me fais comme ça, je dis que si la pluie tombait sur moi, ensuite elle
And he was completely paralyzed down below, you see. But he got hold of my feet and started crying. He said, "My mother, please forgive me." See, this is what intelligence is, and this is what intuition is. All right? So try to develop your intuition. And always say yes to everything, but whatever you know will happen. But we, if we decide, no, this should happen like this, it must be like this, it must be like that. If you go on like that, you see, then you will make everybody miserable and you will be miserable. Now, if you have kept the cup like this, then you will say no, like this. Then husband will come and keep it like that. Then you will keep it like that. Go on like that. But if you are a real woman, you said, all right, keep it like that, okay. Right? Keep it. So immediately all the ganas will come to help. Either he'll spill the whole tea on himself, or he will break the ear of the cup. That's how the ganas will help you. So you are the Devi, you see, they will all look after you. But if you want to be men halfway here and there, why should the ganas bother about such half people? I've tried that many a time, it's like that. And I see people, you see, try to show off too much and they just don't know how they get lost ultimately. So the main thing is that you develop your intuition and live with your intuition, and whatever is intuition will come true because intuition is coming from the ganas. Not taped it. Taping it. Right. So the left side is to be developed in a way for ganas to be pleased. And once you develop the ganas with you, nobody can touch you. Today we had gone out and the car was kept there. It was all locked. And I had a very expensive sweater and an extremely expensive shawl inside the car. And suddenly intuition came into my head and I asked him, "Have you really locked the car properly?" They said, "Yes." I said, "Better see." But they said, "Yes." All right. But when we went into the car, they said, "Where's the radio?" Car. So Patrick started looking in his pocket. They started searching here and there. I said that the thief is not going to leave it in the car. He must have taken it away. But all my things were intact. Garag must have beaten them. Don't touch this. Because these are much more expensive than that. But still, they nobody touched it. And they have many deficiencies, which are very interesting, like they always forget things. Always. Forget, this they will leave there, this they will leave there, that they will forget. You see, that's their speciality. You give them the key? Oh, you never gave me the key, they will say. All right, I never gave you the key, all right? So then, now my husband is very tall, so I see everything about his feet. And there it is. So it's very interesting, isn't it? So you should be calm and quiet and collected. Collected. Together. And then you will see how all the ganas are with you. And after some time, your husband will be boxing behind you. In every way, in money matters, in everything. Like, we had lots of profit in our house. So my husband gave him some money and kept his money very nicely in some sort of a, God knows, he said, we get a big interest with that. I said, all right, it's all right. And I bought a house, a little, small little part of the Hounslow house. And the house has now achieved the price 7 times. And its savings now are not even 1/4 of what I have. It's not even 1/4 now. The savings are. So now he's saying, should I buy a house? If you say, I'll buy a house. I said, not now, because it's the highest price. It is the highest price now. He says, how do you know economics? Just intuition. And he's an honor of economics and he's got gold medals, you bet.
Yeah, doctorat en économie avec mention.
They are so intelligent that they lack common sense and practical sense. See, they have one type of a dress, they go on wearing it. You can change so many times, do this. They have no time, they are gross. Common sense they don't have. So, you are a compliment to them. They are good at laws and regulations and things, said, you must accept what they are saying. And if they say do this or do that, you must accept, because they know that part. They are conversant with that part. And should never argue. You cannot achieve anything after a with argument. All right? Now, this is for one question. Now, which is the other one?